we look at the mid-sagittal brain, you're going to look at the frontal lobe, you're going to have the parietal lobe here, and you're going to have the occipital lobe here. Here's the cerebellum or the arbor vitae, okay? Here's the corpus callosum that basically connects the right hemisphere to the left hemisphere. Then you have the ventricles here. Remember, ventricles are a space that houses cerebrospinal fluid. And you make about 1500 mLs of cerebrospinal fluid a day, and the choroid plexus, which is this pink part, is responsible for making that. You'll have the thalamus right here. You have a right and left thalamus. And then you have the hypothalamus right here. Again, the spinal cord, medulla oblongata, and the pons is right here. Here's the corpora quadrigemma, where the superior part is the superior colliculus, and the inferior is the inferior colliculus. Now remember, these are spaces which are called ventricles. By default, the right ventricle is known as ventricle 1. Ventricle 2 is the left ventricle. The third ventricle is right in here. I call it the bird's beak. And then if you follow the aqueduct, and the tail becomes the fourth ventricle right here. Now ventricles house cerebral spinal fluid. Okay, so again, frontal lobe, parietal lobe, occipital lobe, temporal lobe would be right here. This is the cerebellum. This white structure is known as the arbor vitae, or tree of life. Spinal cord, medulla oblongata, pons. Okay, this is the thalamus, hypothalamus, right in here. Okay, this is the corpus callosum. Choroid plexus is the pink, and that is the ventricle. So then it's the left side, that technically would be ventricle number 2.